So finally, after waiting for so long, the fall season is here, and of course we already live reacted to Bleach, and now it's time for Chainsaw Man, a series that I have been anticipating for quite a long time due to reading it on a weekly basis when it came out, and of course part two is of course coming out weekly. But of course there's something special about Chainsaw Man, not only with the series itself but also the production itself has been very highly anticipated, of course being one of the first studios, not the first probably, but one of the most notable studios to really go all out, 100% investment into a series such as Chainsaw Man. And I think after all the trailers and all the hype that it's generated over these years, it's time to really check it out, and I'm excited because as a fan, genuinely a fan of this series, I'm really interested to see how it really holds up. And let's just get into it. Of course we do see Kobeni in the opening, which I have already watched, because again I imagine I'm going to really just get blasted with copyright if I do show that opening. But I have seen it. I have mixed opinions on it, which I'll probably delve into towards the end. But let's just get into this because I'm really excited to watch Chainsaw Man. So, starting off in the alley. Now, I can't remember how the manga starts off. I'm going to assume that this is the case here with young Denji or maybe old Denji. I can't remember. But great POV shot camera angles right here. And the door. Don't open the door, Denji. For those who know, you know. Don't open the door. And I believe we saw this in one of the trailers, actually, where he wakes up with Pochita, our lovable mascot of the series. So far, pretty standard, but looks gorgeous nonetheless. So money, cutting down trees, and then selling body parts, right, and his kidneys and his right eye, and then he sold. Imagine selling one of your nuts, man. Like... I think bro is like 15 here, so like man sold one of his nuts and it still didn't pay off whatever debt that he had. I can't even imagine that, man. Devil hunting pays the best. I would imagine so. And here's the opening. Okay. Which, again, I think is beautiful. It didn't really hit me at first. The music, I think, how shall I say this? The first half of the song isn't that great for me, but it's the chorus that really hits. And in regardless to the opening as well, the visuals are very chaotic, and this is where like I'm at two halves of it, because I get that the series is chaotic and the opening itself is extremely chaotic as well, so it does take a few watches for the opening for you to really appreciate it, because there's also a lot of different movie references and a lot of different references to the series as a whole in this. But again, it's here where it really kicks off with the chorus and the action and really a sense of what the series is about. And it is chaotic, so it will be alien watching it at first, but once you really get into it, you really get to appreciate it more and more and more. It's a slow burner, I will say. And we get into the episode. Let's go. Oh, we don't actually see him get to fight the devil. Ah, that's unfortunate. It's the tomato devil. Okay. So for those that don't know, a devil is only as strong as how it's feared. So the more feared the concept is of the devil, the more stronger it is. It's sad that like he's sold so much of himself, and yet he's still never going to get out of debt. He's paying off really... No, he doesn't owe you nothing. Yeah, his dad owes you the debt. He does do what he is told, because he doesn't know any better. Yeah, it's all he knows, man. Like, it's such a shame for the guy. Bro, you're never gonna pay off that debt. Like, that's the reality of it. But you know what? Considering what people say online, the animation is pretty standard at the moment. Like, these shots, this movement, it's alright. Yeah. But these backgrounds and these attentions to details for the environment is beautiful and absolutely stunning. Oh, here we go. We get a bit of backstory now. He does what he is told. He's literally your dog, essentially, unironically. And you're still, like, threatening him? Oh, wait. Again, this is... So his dad offs himself, so the kid has to then do the debt. Okay, it doesn't make sense. That's a bit... This is where he meets Pochita, though, and this is cute. Oh, he's wounded. I remember now, yes. Denji's always putting others first before himself, and that's really commendable as well. Is this like the first time he kills a devil for them? Why don't you hire me as a devil hunter? Yeah, that's good. Good idea, Denji. Good idea. And then this is where we are now. See, he doesn't really understand life. He's never had a proper life, so even having jam on bread is like something that sounds, you know, such a luxury to him because he doesn't know any better. And that's, oh yeah, man's coughing. Well, what's he coughing? Why is he coughing? I forgot. Again, like, I haven't reread Chainsaw Man in ages. Oh, heart disease. Christ, man. My man's just down on his luck. I mean, we know that, but... Is the upside down camera shot there kind of insinuating that the world's about to be turned upside down for him? That's the kind of vibe I got from the direction there. CGI hasn't been that bad as well so far. But so far, it's been alright. You know, composited well. You're as loyal as a dog. Yeah, because that's all you've taught me how to be. Raw. And they turn to zombies. Nice. Damn. It really be your own. So he wants to kill him in fear that Denji gets stronger? Is a bit... I mean, sure, I guess. But you already admitted that he was loyal, so I mean, he probably wouldn't have. Yeah, man got stabbed though, and he's still running, so... Fair play. Not many people could do that at all. And again, the CGI zombies, they don't look that bad, to be fair. Damn. Is that a machete? That's gotta hurt. Oh yeah, I forgot about this scene. Yeah, he does get chopped up. It is gruesome. It is kind of... The voice acting's great. Damn. Man literally got sliced and diced. And then thrown in the bin. Rip my dude, man. He got decapitated too. That's crazy. Now what if that drop of blood never went in Pochita's mouth? Then this story would never have happened. And now we're gonna get like the sad backstory. Which to be fair, was already sad as it was. I don't really think we need the backstory. I think we already feel sorry for the situation that is in. But it's always nice to see the dynamic between Pochita and Denji. Oh, and then he's even going as far as to offer him his body. That's nice of him. I mean, he'd be dead anyway, so I mean... It's not like he has a choice in the matter, realistically. Now that's a cute, that is a cute screenshot right there. It just is. Then again, to me, if anything looks like a dog, it's cute, so instant W. And he does, he takes over his body. Well, he doesn't take over it, but he fuses with it for sure and becomes his heart. In exchange, I want you to show me your dream. And he's got his eye back and probably his nuts too. It's time. Go on, Denji. These guys have plenty already, so why do they want even more? Because that's all they want, bro. You were never going to get out of debt. Pull the string. Pull it. Is that the chainsaw goat? There we go. Yeah, the CG was fine. I don't know. You did this, bro. I think it's ironic that he went for the eye that Denji never had. Well, did have, but... So he's kind of just taking back what he took away from him, which is funny. Nah, not gonna work. This is great. Yeah. Nice. Yo, he's just jumping on heads to get to him. Yeah. Yeah. Man glided to him. Nice. Oh, and he just speeds up the rotor. Okay, maybe... It's a bit iffy there, but it's okay, it's okay. You finish the job, Denji. Get rid of them all. I'd save him for last. I'd save the geese that made you do all those jobs for last, bro. Get that nice, sweet revenge. Though, I will say, I did see some fan animations a little bit better and choreographed, but I'm satisfied with it. Everybody knows who this is, if you know anything about Chainsaw Man. And here she is. Yes, he did. And you know damn well, Makima, what he did. Oh, that's a nice way for it to... Yeah, they animated that really well, for it to disappear.
Two
Or you could just let him have a third option and just let him go, personally. Bread and butter and jam, salad, coffee. Nice breakfast. Dessert for breakfast? Okay, and there you go. No visuals for the ending? Okay, honest opinion and thoughts on this, because I don't think it deserves, not that it doesn't deserve, but I don't think there's really much for me to say in terms of a review. Considering, again, as a manga reader, this adaptated it really well. Like, it really did. I have no complaints about anything. The animation was great. CG was a bit overblown out of proportion online. I thought the CG was absolutely fine. Would I be wrong in saying that this felt slow? And maybe that's fine, because again, we're getting into Denji, about his character, about everything about what Chainsaw Man is, right? And it doesn't really encapsulate that in this episode yet. And that's understandable, because I think it laid down the foundations for Denji's character about what he's about and what his goals and ambitions are, which are extremely simplistic and extremely understandable considering the life that he's had to live. We get a little bit about Pochita, and Pochita's just adorable, and we get the introduction of Makima, which is the red-haired girl that you see. Now, if you are watching Chainsaw Man for the first time, you are absolutely probably going to love this a lot. However, if you have been oversaturated with Chainsaw Man like you have online, or you've read the manga, or you've even seen the growth of Chainsaw Man over the years, I feel a little bit, slightly, satisfied and unsatisfied at the same time, because I feel I've seen so many fan animations of this series. I kind of exposed to so many different scenarios, and I expected a little bit more from the zombie battle. I don't know what it was, but it felt like it was a little bit slow and missing something. That's just me. I felt like on a standard fundamental level, it was great. I love the blood effects. I feel like it was hand-drawn when it was needed to be hand-drawn. I don't expect animators to draw all these different zombies, and the CG that was used was absolutely fine, and it really fit because the compositing was really great, and it really blended in well. I think the backgrounds looked absolutely stunning. The art department and the colour department absolutely did a fantastic job. And of course, you have movement when movement was needed. But it felt a little bit slow, and that's fine, because this is the introduction episode. I definitely would suggest that Chainsaw Man is going to get higher peaks from here on out, and it was a great setup episode, a great start, and this covered, I believe, just one entire chapter. So it's incomparable to, again, a series that I do on this channel called Bleach. If you don't know about it, if you are a fan about it, go check it out. Obviously, hit the like and subscribe for more, you know, Chainsaw Man live reactions and Bleach live reactions. But it's incomparable because you have one chapter of Chainsaw Man, and then you have, I believe it is one chapter, correct me if I'm wrong, compared to five chapters from Bleach that was, you know, adapted in that episode in comparison to this one. So things are going to seem a little bit slower. However, first half of the episode was obviously introduction, and the second half was introducing Denji's powers. And quite frankly, I'm very happy with it, and I'm very satisfied with it. I don't think it's a 10 out of 10. I'd say it's a solid 8. To be honest with you, I don't know what it was really missing, but I did enjoy the cinematography a lot. And again, the opening is a slow burner for me. Other than that, great episode. Yeah, there's not really anything for me to say is wrong with the episode. So I liked it. I feel like it's a bit of a disappointing live reaction, but do you know what? I'm very much excited to really get into introducing Power, seeing Aki, getting into the Bat Devil, so to say. That's going to be fun, because I think we're just getting a little bit of a glimpse of like what's to come, and I don't think they put all their eggs in one basket in this episode. So, and again, 12 episodes, because it's going to be the first core, and there's going to be 12 different endings. With 12 different endings, I will say I am a little bit disappointed that there is no, like, ending visuals, because we got 12 big name people on the ending soundtracks through each episode, right? So I kind of thought they would have at least maybe respected the artist by putting some kind of visuals. But if I believe correctly, MAPPA are doing their own type of AMVs with the endings on their channel. So they're definitely making use of the songs that they have acquired. It's just a bit weird that they haven't put it in the show, but maybe that's just me. That being said though, that's kind of just my thoughts off the top of the bat. If you want any more live reactions, do tell me in the comment section down below. I'll probably do them anyway because I enjoy them. And I enjoy Chainsaw Man, so I'm excited to see the direction that this is going to go. And I'm extremely excited and interested to see where the pacing is going to go. But I need to see more Kobeni. So I definitely will have to keep live reacting until I see more Kobeni. With that being said, though, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.